AWS Direct Connect is a way that you can connect a on-premises data center or office location into AWS using a private connection. So in other words, we're not using the internet. We're actually using a private network link into AWS. And this can give us some significant advantages in terms of the bandwidth as well as the latency and ensuring that we have consistent network performance. Does come at a cost. It's definitely going to cost more than if you just establish an AWS managed VPN across the internet. But at the same time, for a lot of companies, this provides some significant advantages. And if you do send a lot of data to AWS, it can even lower costs. So let's have a look at the configuration of Direct Connect. So we have an AWS region with a VPC, and we've got a corporate data center, or it could be an office. And what we want to do is connect that corporate data center to AWS. Now to do so, we have to connect via what's called an AWS Direct Connect location. And these can be found in many cities around the world. So in the Direct Connect location, there's something called an AWS cage, and that's where AWS have their networking equipment. And then there's a customer or a partner cage. Customer means it would be yours, so you would own a rack in that data center with your own networking equipment. A partner simply means that there's a APN partner that is partnered with AWS, and they have their own cage with networking equipment, and you can get a connection into their cage, and they do the connectivity into AWS. So the way it works is there are routers in each of these cages in the Direct Connect location, and a DX port must be allocated in the DX location. So this is a port into which you are then going to plug a cross connect. The cross connect is a cable that goes between the customer or partner cage into the DX port that's been allocated in the AWS cage. We then have the customer router in the corporate data center, and we need to connect that to the DX router in the DX location. So that's when we form the end-to-end connection. So AWS obviously have their connection from their cage into Direct Connect in the region, but then you must connect from your corporate data center to the customer partner cage. Now this is where some expense and some challenge can take place, because you'll find that you might need to connect from your data center into this location if you don't have a pre-existing connection. And sometimes that can actually cost quite a bit of money, and it can take quite a bit of time as well. So this is not something you can set up very quickly. With Direct Connect, we say weeks to months. That's how long it's going to take to provision. The actual DX connection is a physical fiber connection to AWS, and it runs at either 1 gigabit per second or 10 gigabits per second. Now you can get lower numbers than that, so you can get smaller bandwidth, and we'll talk about that in a moment. So what are the key benefits? You get private connectivity between AWS and your data center or office. You get consistent network experience. That means you can get increased speed and lower latency and consistent latency, and you can get improved throughput and high bandwidth. It can lower costs for organizations that transfer a large volume of data. Let's look at a bit more detail. So once we've established the physical connection, we then have to create something called a virtual interface. There are public and private virtual interfaces. A private virtual interface connects to a single VPC in the same AWS region using a virtual private gateway, a VGW. A VIF is essentially a virtual interface that's using 802.1Q VLAN tagging, and it also is a BGP session. Now, the next type of VIF we have is this public VIF. What that does is it connects you to the AWS public services in any region. So the private VIF goes into the same region as the actual physical connection, but the public VIF can connect you to a public service in any region. It doesn't connect you to the internet, so you can't use it for then connecting to the internet via the public VIF. So what if you have multiple VPCs in the region? Well, in that case, you can have multiple VGWs, and multiple private VIFs can be used to connect to those VGWs. So you're connecting to multiple VPCs. Each one is connected over a separate private VIF. VIFs can also be shared with other AWS account, and when you do that, it's known as a hosted VIF. Now, you can get speeds of 50 megabits per second to 500 megabits per second and various combinations of those values if you use an APN partner. An APN partner will have a connection already to AWS, and essentially they're giving you a subset of that connection. Now, there's a couple of different types of ways this is implemented, either a hosted VIF or a hosted connection. A hosted VIF is a single VIF that is shared with other customers. So in that case, you get shared bandwidth. Or you use a hosted connection. That is a DX connection with a single VIF dedicated to you. So obviously there's a cost implication to these, but if you go with what's probably going to be the cheaper option, the hosted VIF, you've got to ensure that you understand that there's shared bandwidth happening there. Whereas with the hosted connection, it's dedicated to you. So you might have to consider that and whether it's worth paying the extra money. Really important to note that DX connections are not encrypted. This is not an inherently secure technology. If anybody managed to get to the ports in the data center or compromise either the partner rack or even the AWS rack or your connection somewhere along the line, they could potentially sniff the data off the connection, so they could actually get access to that data. So if it's unencrypted, then that's a security risk. So you've got to understand that. Now, what can you do if you want to make sure your data is encrypted? Well, you can have an IPsec site-to-site VPN connection running over a VIF to add encryption in transit. So essentially, you're running Direct Connect, and on top of Direct Connect, you're then encrypting the traffic that goes over that Direct Connect using an AWS Managed VPN connection. Link aggregation groups, or LAGs, can be used to combine multiple physical connections into a single logical connection, and it uses something called LACP, the Link Aggregation Control Protocol. Now, this is for improved speed. It's not going to give you improved high availability. So just remember that. This is not a high availability configuration, but it gives you better speed, better bandwidth. Now, on the subject of high availability, let's look at how you can design and implement Direct Connect to make sure you have high availability built into these connections. After all, if you're using Direct Connect, it's obviously very important to your business, so you've got to make sure you consider these options. So, we know that we have a region, and then we have a Direct Connect location, and then a corporate data center. And then we have these various things. We have the AWS router, we have the partner or customer router, and then we have the router in the customer data center. AWS supply the connection from the region into their router, and those are redundant. So that's already a redundant connection, so you don't have to worry about this part. So we have the cross connect and then the connection to the corporate data center. Now, there's a few single points of failure here. Firstly, we have the actual AWS router here. The port in the router could fail. Next, we have the customer or partner router, and then we have the router in the customer data center. We also have the actual cable itself, the cross connect between these two routers, and the cable to the corporate data center. We've also got the actual location itself. What if something caused a major outage in the location and the corporate data center? So there's quite a few single points of failure. So what could we do to improve this? Well, we can add in some more routers. So we've got another port here on the AWS side. We've got another connection coming from AWS to that port. We've then got another cross connect and another connection to two additional routers. So now we have more redundancy. Bear in mind that the physical cables here are going from this physical location to this physical location. So these two cables could actually share the same pathway. So if something happened, like a digger came along, dug up a road and took out some cables, well, in that case, both of these could go at the same time. So we still have the two locations as well. Those are still single points of failure. So how do we then take it to the next level? Well, now we have two Direct Connect locations, two corporate data centers, and we have redundancy built into each one of them. So now this is the really highly available architecture. Bear in mind that multiple DX locations exist in metropolitan areas where AWS has a region, so you should have multiple options for DX locations. So this is obviously going to be a considerably more expensive setup than if you just had the very low levels of redundancy. As you add redundancy, you always add cost, but you've got to consider your business and what is the impacts of an outage and what is the likelihood of an outage, and then work out if that cost is acceptable to you. Now, another thing you can do to add redundancy is, rather than adding additional AWS Direct Connect connections, you can add an IPsec VPN. So here we have the DX connection, and that is the primary active path. We have a VGW, and this VGW is connected back to the corporate data center using a site-to-site VPN, and that is the backup path. So now you're prioritizing your traffic to use the Direct Connect link, but if the DX link fails for some reason, you've got a backup path via the internet. Of course, you've got to then consider, how well is the internet going to work? What is your internet bandwidth? Will the latency across the internet potentially have an impact on you? You can never guarantee latency on the internet. It can vary widely and from day to day or hour to hour. So you've got to consider whether that's an option which is acceptable to your business, but it will be significantly cheaper than having a fully redundant DX configuration. Now, bear in mind that multiple single points of failure do exist in the architecture I'm showing you here. So then you would just go in and add redundancy where you need to. Again, considering that each time you do that, you're going to add some cost, but you're going to lower your risk of an outage happening. A recommendation from AWS is that you do not use this architecture if your speeds are over 1 gigabits per second. So if you need more than 1 gigabits per second of bandwidth, don't use this setup. And that's because of limitations in the AWS VPN. So that's it for Direct Connect. What we'll do in the next lesson is I'll take you into the console and show you how you would go about setting up Direct Connect.